The views and opinions expressed do not necessarily represent those of Access Fort Wayne, the Allen County Public Library, or any other supporting group. Get involved with Access Fort Wayne and make your own television programming. Call 421-1250 to find out more.
Friends, Lumber Grave Shop. How's it going, man?
Oh, it's going well. How about you?
Not too bad. We kind of go way back, similar with media styles from way back then. You know, me doing public access, you doing weather for forever. So now you're hosting events. How's that working out for you?
Yeah, I've been doing this for about 3-4 years now as a mainstay. So it's kind of fun. Yeah, I like the Johhny Appleseed Festival. There's nothing like it. You know, it's a big, beautiful festival. And weather's great this year, so I don't know if we could ask for anything more.
If you could change anything about the festival, what would that be?
What's that?
If you could change anything about the festival.
Nothing? No, it's great. I think they do a wonderful job. They've got it refined to an art.
So you're going to be here every year then?
Yeah, as long as I'm able to, I'll be here at this stage.
Now, you're a weatherman. You're popular. You've been all over Fort Wayne and stuff like that. Anything you say to anybody that wants to be getting into weather or anybody wants to get into entertainment?
Do a lot of math. Get some calculus and physics in high school.
Anything you say to the fans before we go?
No, just thanks for supporting me.
Thank you.
Okay.
Good job then.
Yeah. I guess so.
Here's the book. This is my favorite history book. Richard Balzer and only Richard Balzer's book on peep shows.
Yeah.
This covers that 1700 to 1850 period before photography when this is who they were for.
Right.
And it's the easiest day they're ever going to make. I'm not kidding.
Thank you.
Sure. And the rest of these are, we have some curios out. We have a severed head in the box. Knife. You know what a severed head is?
Sure.
So you know what it is? Head no longer attached to the body?
Yeah.
This is the head of the historical Faust. Johann Faust was an alchemist, born in about 1480, and in 1540, about the age of 60, trying to get, as an alchemist, alchemists were scientists, early scientists, they were experimenting with chemicals, really. And he tried to separate, because copper looked almost like gold. You cut into copper, it looks even more like gold. So he thought, gold's in there. He tried to add chemicals to it to separate the copper from the gold. You know what's in copper, son?
Copper.
What he got was an explosion. Blew himself to pieces. And the news spread across Europe and inspired the Faust plays. A man greedy enough to blow himself to pieces is the man that inspired Faust and Dr. Faustus. We have the head of the historical Faust in our box. That's what he looked like in life.
Not a good day.
Dr. Faust, yeah? What'd you learn about alchemy?
I learned that alchemy does not work.
Yeah. Why's your head in the box?
I got greedy. Don't be greedy.
Don't you like the head?
Any questions?
Any questions for the head?
You all right? Is that right? Close the door. Someone here knows that. The reason I have a head in a box is because when we were younger than any kid I see here, we saw the greatest ventriloquist who ever lived. His name was Senor, Spanish for Mr., Wences, W-E-N-C-E-S.
He was the best.
And you can find him, and this is the only time I say this. Go to YouTube. This kills me. But that's where you'll find Senor Wences. Have you ever seen this puppet? He invented it.
Had a little body.
He had a small head in a box. And if you go to YouTube and see maybe four of his shows, make sure you see the one where he builds puppets on his hands in front of you. You'll never see better. I mean, 60 years after I saw him, exactly. 60 years after I saw him, I got a head in a box.
It took me
it lasted. Yeah, but we both knew who he was every minute.
We are back at the Tawny Appleseed Festival, and it's not turning out too bad today, with it being the Sunday. Here we're gonna see what we can fit her out, see what else is going on out here. Stay tuned for more. We are back out at the Tawny Appleseed Festival. I am with
Shane.
And what is your kids' names?
We have Owen, Damien, and Skylar.
And what you guys are thinking about the festival so far?
So far we're thinking it's pretty good.
What you guys think?
Good.
What about you?
Do you like the festival?
You like the festival?
She's gonna be shy.
You like the festival? She's shaking her head yes. Why are you guys are entwined about it so far?
Well, they got to go down and do the maze, and later we're gonna go pet the animals.
Ooh.
And looking through all the shops and the vendors.
Awesome.
They seem to want something from about everyone.
Oh, yeah. Like most people.
Yep.
Thank you.
All right, no problem.
See, festival, I am actually going to have a roll interview with some of our crew members. What are you guys thinking about it out here so far?
It's good.
Yeah.
And what do you guys did?
Root beer.
Root beer.
Have you had it before around here?
A few years ago, yeah.
Anything else you guys thinking about saying?
Huh? I think we're going over to look at the shops on the other side here in a little bit.
Awesome. Thank you.
Yep.
You're welcome.
Thank you. On this stage, I think it's become almost a tradition that we end with them. Mom and Pop and Fresh. Give them a big hand. Welcome them to the stage.
Thank you. Thank you very much. We're the Mom and Pop and Fresh Band. And we're kind of a family act. There's a mom, and I'm the pop, and he's a fresh, and we have some freshettes, young ladies. My daughters are wandering around out there somewhere. I'm hoping they can join us on the stage for soon. But maybe I think I'm hearing them clapping or something. Yeah. All right, girls. Hit it.
Thank you.
come on down. Oh, fathers, let's go down, down in the river to pray. As I went down in the river to pray, studying about that good old way. And
has a very long history here in the U.S. as well. It's very popular up in New England, and actually of all places, up in Michigan, where there's literally hundreds of players in this tour. And here in Indiana, there's a few of us. Both Bev and I play. Bev, of course, today is playing her guitar. But the hammer dulcimer is basically a lot of strings stretched over a couple of bridges, and are played with small sticks like this.
Yeah.
That's basically it.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Can you play another song for us?
We sure can. You want to do Cold Frosty Morning? Yeah. That's okay. You want to go ahead and prepare for that? Okay. She's going to play a very unique percussion instrument. Has a very long history in America as well. These are called limberjacks. And limberjacks, basically, you bounce the board and it causes little figures to dance. And while it's dancing, it also creates a rhythmic pattern.
Right now.
birthday career at four. Bye bye. Oh, it's my one to remember. He's out in the building too.
Yeah.
You're around here so.
Step number five. You forgot the battery.
There you go.
How'd you forget the battery, dude?
You have two buttons on your steering wheel behind your no bumping pad. The green button on the right is your power-up button. When you drive over a green to yellow question mark square, you will get power-up displayed on the screen in front of it. Press this button to activate it. On your left is a red reverse button. If you get stuck or spin out, press this button, you'll be able to back yourself up. In order to gain speed and win the race, you'll want to drive over the yellow coin spots. Watch out for other colored spots on the track. They can slow you down and even remove your power-up. Please remember to keep hands and feet inside the car at all times, and please refrain from bumping or hitting each other, or you may be removed from the race. If something is wrong with your car, please raise your hand, and a staff member will come to you. Are there any questions? Okay.
Wes is number five, Tin Camp.
Way, that's the highway, that's the best. City, Chaplin, Missouri, Oklahoma City, looks so, so pretty, you'll see, Amarillo, Gallup, New Mexico, Flagstaff, Arizona, don't forget Winona, Kane, and Paso, San Bernardino, won't you get hip to this time of tip, and take that California trip. Kicks on Route 66.
Festival is going really, really well. Our numbers are way up. We're actually above the pre-pandemic level. So that's good. We've got really good numbers. We're really happy.
This is on the first day.
Yeah. Well, yeah. I mean, as far as number of vendors, you know, the Scoup rides, the first time they've been back.
since the pandemic. We're excited about that. It's been such a big day this year. We've got a lot of our food bands ran out of food already this year. So that's pretty exciting. We're really looking forward to another good day tomorrow. Looks like the weather's going to hold off for us. So we were worried about rain, but now I don't think it's going to rain until the festival's over. So that's really good.
Oh, that's good.
That's really good. And so, yeah, it's just turned out to be a really, really good festival. It's the first time in a long time we haven't had really hot weather. I think that's helped too.
Yeah.
When the weather's not too hot, the food vendors do it.
Yeah. And what about the pianists? It feels like there's a lot more people.
I think so. I think a couple of things happened today for the first day. I think we had a really big uptick in attendance today because I think early this morning people were coming out because earlier today it looked like Sunday was going to be rainy. Now it doesn't look like it's going to be rainy, but earlier this morning it was going to be chance of rain. Let's go today so we don't get rained on. But now it looks like tomorrow's not going to be rainy. So I think that made a big push. But it's just been, I think people are ready for it. It's been a long summer. People are ready for some fall activities.
Exactly. Yeah, how many years have we been going on? Just Jeff is trying to figure it out, and Rachel not remember.
The 48th Johhny Appleseed Festival, and let's see, next year will be Johnny's 250th, I guess, his birthday. So it'll be his 250th anniversary, and then, in 2 years, it'll be our 50th, so
oh, wow, some exciting years coming up.
I know. I won't be here for next year's festival because my daughter's getting married. I know. You had to pick that week up.
Aww.
Yeah. So, it'll be fun. What's your favorite part of the festival?
Oh, I don't know. Seeing all the different entertainment, all the different people.
Yeah.
Turning out really well.
The pony.
Yeah.
They won't let me ride it.
They won't. How has it been going with the pony rides?
Pony rides have been a big hit, we're excited because last year was the first time we had it.
Feels like it's
going to roll. Well, I'm going to throw you back.
That's exactly. Wow.
A lot. All right, bye.
Last year was the first year we had them here. It was the first big public event they had done since they had left the zoo. So we got them back here, and people were really excited to have them here. And they were really excited to have them back. They loved it. They had no idea how to do it because they'd always been right at the zoo for years. So when they came here, they had no idea what to expect last year. And they were blown away. The ponies ended up loving it. They love giving rides.
Yeah.
And so they were just like,
so happy.
Like, woo, once they got started, they were like, what's going on? And they got started, they were like, so, yeah.
That's awesome. Thank you.
You're welcome. Thanks for coming out.
Yeah.
Yep, you too.
Fort base.
Yeah.
Combination.
Is it recording?
Yeah.
Yeah, I've got to pick my word over. Come on, let's get around by the ropes.
Seems pretty fun.
Over here.
Okay.
We're doing a magic trick here. This guy really do right. You can't keep going.
You got it
rolling? Yeah, I gotta go on.
Here, Barron, I have Tony Appleseed Festival. I am with
Jim Barron.
Can you tell us about your masses?
Well, I started when I was 10, and I've been doing it ever since. There's a guy named Dick Stoner in this town. And Dick is a great magician. He's a mentor of mine. And I went and started going to his school when I was 10. And
Army!
Keep it going. Hey, people, how you doing?
Well, I'll tell you, that's easy. Because I'm also a radio announcer. And I do a morning show, WBCL. Yeah, I've been there 20 years, so, you know, you can either find me online or you can just call me.
Give me a nice hand.
Easy enough.
You want to roll it back? Okay.
Yeah.
And when is your
I got that ring. He got that ring. How you doing, sir? Green glasses.
Awesome. Thank you.
Yeah, sure. Cool. Hey, thanks.
Yep.
Nice meeting you.
Yep.
Sir. Are you like the Green Hornet?
Yeah. Where's the bottle? Nate. Yeah. We done a bottle. Like they were throwing it in his face.
What are they called?
The sinus right here.
Follow the pipes.
seems like everybody's saying the same.
Lead us to the stage almost, so there we go.
It works out perfect. People tend to stop when they come. Plums.
Local history. Johhny Appleseed, lived and died here in this area.
The answer is yes. We've got some seeds.
Fabulous. Good deal. And everybody knows the story of Johhny Appleseed. I don't need to repeat all that. He was an extraordinary.
God is
he wasn't
cement.
Just a country bumpkin.
He's going to send man to him. He must tell like that. Third. There we go.
It really is kind of the Three Rivers Festival in the summer. Of course, it's scattered all over the county, whereas this is I don't know what the history of attendance, but it's been tens of thousands of people, and I'd say today's a record-breaking crowd.
Yeah, see, it just started like 2 or 3 hours ago.
Yes.
I was assuming
yeah,
good, time
it, a wholesome festival food, and up on the hill, craftsmen. Cranking out beautiful and useful objects, and I know the settlers are there demonstrating kind of historic hand arts, ones that everybody can do in their home, so you can watch them processing textiles and spinning and such, and it's quite fascinating. Of course, all the, now what new this year, to my left and to the west, the Buckskinner camp was moved from along Parnell to right here along the river. So off in the off in this way here. So I haven't got down there, but the vendors of the 1840s and the Western fur trade era inspired the Buckskinner camp. Oh, I wondered why you were so familiar, and it just hit me. So, we're having a great time here, and it's all day tomorrow, too. Well, not all day, but from 10 a.m. and anywhere much earlier.
Oh, yeah.
I don't have the hours. You can get that. So,
you're doing your thing,
a lot of families, a lot of young people, and just a lot to see and do. It's wonderfully organized. Wonderfully organized. And quite a wonderful event to be a part of. Well, my favorite part is the history. Now, when we had youngsters, then your favorite part might be something in the children's area. But I love our local history, and I love American history. So we've got a Revolutionary War regiment, the 13th Pennsylvania down there. We have a lot of American Civil War.
Mom's getting tired.
Jack Gable.
Got it.
A lot of help in the camp kitchen. You can imagine feeding tens of thousands of soldiers during the American Civil War. But a lot of good. And the new boss are here demonstrating how to process chocolate. Before Hershey's and before Instant Quick, it was very involved in digital watching and processing from the beans to the edible chocolate. Just right here in the
camp. I check that out.
Yeah, it's a great demonstration. Yeah, check it out.
So I know you're in this coming up, and you say the before you go.
Cannon fire on the hour, so you better put a muffler on your microphone.
Yes. Well, you're out of the water, yes. Which is not
yeah,
the water.
Come out to the Johhny Appleseed Festival, parking at the Coliseum. Or you can, I didn't see the buses, but in the past they've been free parking at Purdue and Concordia, and then ride the shuttle bus.
Yeah, that's
good
deal.
Yeah.
But see you guys later on What's This Evening.
So what are you making?
I'm making Windsor Cheer. Windsor Cheers. This is the seat. It's the pork part right here, the seat.
Oh, yeah.
Getting the right angle.
You've been doing this for years?
Yeah, I've been doing it for a while. Lands into the seat coming from above, which is what I'm doing right now for the spindles. And you have the legs and the brace going underneath. And you sit on it and get started.
Now, how long does this normally take you?
This particular seat here is going to be a continuous arm. It might take 40 hours.
Ooh.
40 hours. So it just depends on which kind of a chair I'm doing. It could be 50 for a home mat. More intensive and more work. Yeah. I get all the angles correct. Which adds to the strength of it. Everything's falling into place. So, this is what we're doing right now. Make sure these spindles are at the right angle. Double gauge.
That one's going this way.
Another angle here. here for a while at this festival. Hope you guys are enjoying it. Once again, the Inclognito Cloggers, and kind of an Irish piece, Dance Above the Rainbow. The Inclognito Cloggers from Ligonier, Indiana, and they are getting set for their next piece. Still got a few more pieces to go. At 11 o'clock on this stage, the Suzuki...
first time. It's like I'm living for the first time. Finally living for the first time. It's like I'm living for the first time.